Two-dimensional vectors, level 5. In this video, we will go over various examples that make use of vector operations, specifically vector addition, vector subtraction, and scalar multiplication. We will solve these problems by using the geometric interpretation of these particular vector operations. Alright, let's go over the first example. Write each combination of vectors as a single vector. Alright, here we have line segments, connected by various vertices. Since these are line segments, we are free to assign the direction of vectors by appropriately denoting the initial and terminal points. Let's start with the first example. Here, we are asked to find the sum of vector CB and vector BA. First, let's identify each of the vectors on the diagram. Vector CB is located here, and vector BA is here. Next, we go ahead and add the vectors geometrically by applying the triangle law. Notice that the tail of vector BA is aligned with the head of vector CB. All that is left to do is to draw and determine the resultant vector. In this case, the vector will extend from the tail of vector CB towards the head of vector BA. Looking at the diagram, we see that this vector can be denoted as vector CA, and this is the resulting vector. Alright, let's try the next example. Here, we are asked to add vector AC and vector CD. Like in the previous example, let's go ahead and apply the triangle law for vectors. Notice that the tail of vector CD is aligned with the head of vector AC. This means that the resulting vector is going to have an initial point at A and a terminal point located at D. In other words, the resulting vector would be vector AD. Let's try the next problem. Here, we are asked to find the difference between vector BD and vector CD. Let's first identify vector BD and vector CD. Now, in order to carry out this difference, we can think about this problem as a special case of adding vectors. In this case, we are adding the negative of vector CD to vector BD. So, if we were to take vector CD and align its tail to the head of vector BD, we would obtain the following. Now we need to flip vector CD so that it points in the opposite direction, as follows. Now we go ahead and apply the triangle law. Notice that the resulting vector in this example would be equal to vector BC. Alright, let's try the next example. Here, we are asked to find the sum of vector AD, vector DC, and vector CB. When adding more than two vectors, the procedure is essentially the same. You want to add the vectors by using the tail-to-head method. You can think of this process as applying the triangle law multiple times. In the end, the resulting vector will have its initial point at A and terminal point at B. Thus, the resulting vector would be vector AB. Alright, let's move along and try a different type of problem. Given vectors U, V, and W, draw and label the resulting vector of the following vector expressions. Okay, in this problem, we are provided with three distinct vectors, each with their own magnitude and direction. The first vector expression is asking us to find and draw the resulting vector when vector u and vector v are added. We can geometrically find the sum by applying the triangle law. So we go ahead and align the tail of vector v with the head of vector u, as follows. The resultant vector will then have its initial point located at the tail of vector u, and its terminal point at the head of vector v. Alternatively, we can also make use of the parallelogram law and align the tails of both vectors together, and then make copies of each vector that are parallel to one another, forming the sides of the parallelogram. Using this method, we can draw the resulting vector by starting at the intersection where the tails of both vectors coincide, and extending the directed line segment along the diagonal of the parallelogram. Regardless of what method you apply, you should obtain the same resultant vector. Okay, let's try the next example. Here, we are asked to find the resulting vector when we add vector v and vector w. Keep in mind that it really doesn't matter which vector you add first, as long as you follow the triangle law or parallelogram law. Everything should work out. Using the triangle law, we would obtain the following resultant vector. In the same manner, if we use the parallelogram law, we would obtain the same exact resultant vector. Alright, let's try the next example. Here, we need to find the resultant vector when we subtract vector v from vector u. The procedure for subtracting vectors is essentially the same as adding vectors. All we need to do is to make sure we flip the direction of the vector being subtracted. In this case, we first align the vectors by making use of the head-to-tail method, or triangle law. Then, we take vector v and flip it in the opposite direction. From here, the final step is to draw the resulting vector. This vector is drawn just like in the previous examples. We can also use the parallelogram law. When using this method, always make sure you flip the negative vector before applying the parallelogram law. Alright, let's move along to the next example. Here we are asked to add all three vectors. The best way to tackle these types of problems is by applying the triangle law multiple times. So we essentially need to align the head of one vector with the tail of another vector, one after the other, as follows. The resulting vector will have its initial point located in the tail of vector u, and will end at the head of vector w, as follows. Let's try the next example. Here we are asked to carry out a scalar multiplication of vector w. Recall that scalar multiplication scales a vector by changing its length, or in the case of negative scalars, it can also change the direction of a vector. In this example, we are asked to draw vector 2 times w. We can draw this expression by taking vector w and doubling the size or magnitude of the vector, as follows, keeping the same direction as the original vector. Okay, let's try the next problem. Here, we are once again asked to carry out a scalar multiplication. In this example, we are asked to scale vector u by half its size. We also have a negative sign, so we also need to change the vector's direction, so that it points in the opposite direction, as follows. Alright, let's try the next example. Here we are asked to subtract two vectors. In this case, we are asked to find the difference between vector u and 3 times vector v. Similar to vector addition, we need to align the vectors by using the triangle law. In this particular example, we first need to scale vector v by a factor of 3. Then we go ahead and align the tail of vector 3v with the head of vector u. And then we flip vector 3v in the opposite direction, as follows. The resulting vector can then be drawn by connecting the initial point of vector u with the terminal point of vector 3v. Okay, let's go over the final example. Here, we are asked to carry out a scalar multiplication, a sum and difference of vectors. Let's draw the scalar multiplication of each vector. For vector u, we double the length. For vector v, we scale the vector by a third of its original length. And for vector w, we triple its original length. Next, let's go ahead and add vector 2u with vector 1/3 v by using the tail-to-tip method. Next, let's go ahead and take vector 3w and flip it in the opposite direction. Then we go ahead and align the tail of this vector with the tip of vector 1/3 v. The resulting vector would then be drawn from the tail of vector 2u to the tip of vector 3w. Alright, now that we have a better understanding of the geometry of scalar multiplication, vector addition, and vector subtraction, we are ready to learn how to carry out vector operations algebraically. In our next video, we will learn a more powerful and precise method for computing various vector operations.